Hello and welcome to Telepathic TV. This is television you watch with your third eye. I'm our Neville Johnston.
And I'm Mary Phelan, and our program is about raising our consciousness.
Raising consciousness is erasing the way in which you've been taught to think and replacing it with real thinking. The way we've been taught to think is pacocta, is out of it, doesn't work. In fact, we think in a language that doesn't work, which, you know, the books on the language codes is to alert us to the idea that thinking with a word like betrayal is insanity per se. Who's the only person on earth who can betray you? Mm-hmm. This is the way this works. We have to recognize our power, and that's what this show is about. You accepting the idea that you are indeed the creator of your life, you are indeed a limitless creator, and to begin to think that way and act that way. Today, a very different way to think is the way in which we think about time. We'll just announce it.
I drew it.
Okay, go ahead, hold
well,
it up.
Well, I can't reach it right at the moment.
Okay,
but you could
so
probably.
The today in Mayan is eight tone.
Chichan.
Chichan, yeah.
Well, in Chichan, today is a good day. Being a tone eight, it's a good day for exploring options. And since Chichan is about taking things from the physical frequency and ascending it into the spiritual frequency, today's a good day for exploring different options or different vehicles to do that. And I'll go ahead and get this out just to show you the glyph. I drew it because I left the one on my printer. Anyway, that's the glyph for today. Great. And well, thank you for joining us tonight. One of the things we were going to talk about is crystals and minerals and how you can use those to improve your existence, to assist you with progressing, going forward. And the thing about crystals is they really are amplifiers. You know, a lot of times people say, oh, crystals, you know, what's in the energy? You know, that's kind of silly and whatever. And if you think about I am talking to you right now, but yet my real voice isn't what's coming into your living room. It's being conducted, it's being amplified, and it's being conveyed there somehow. So crystals act as amplifiers for us.
Yeah.
So we brought a few little samples of things in just to show you. We're going to be doing a crystal class in a couple of weeks, but we thought we'd just show you a few little specimens, and then we can start the dialogue, or if people have questions, they can call in.
Always.
Shall I start with this?
Sure.
The first piece that I'm going to show you, and I brought some of my collection in with me, this is an amethyst sphere, and there's actually little pieces of where ametrine is. And amethyst is, and this is a really lovely one, it's a deep purple, and I'm just going to move it around as they're focusing on it, just to see if I can catch some of those. It's ametrine is where there's citrine and amethyst in the same place, and it'll have like a little channel where water flowed I don't know what to say, flowed through it when it was still in a liquid form. So it looks like a channel of like a brownish yellow, and that's where citrine is. And citrine is just amethyst with water also. It's magnesium and I can't remember what else is in there, but it's the same as quartz, just with other minerals added to it. But
magnesium.
The properties, isn't that what I said?
I don't know, you may have.
Oh. Mm-hmm. The properties of amethyst are really wonderful. What I use amethyst for is when I can't sleep, I just pick up a sphere and just lay there, and after a few minutes I get sleepy and I fall asleep. And it really works wonderfully. And it's great for meditating with it, you know, just the frequency of it.
Yeah, we'll talk a lot more about applications of all of these things. And they all come with, well, not all of them, but the majority of them come with a legend from ancient times. It's an important piece of you. It's actually a piece of you. We are the crystal kingdom. We've just evolved since we were crystals. If you, we've seen this on the show for about 7 years, and it's unlikely you'd have a clear memory of what it looked like a few years ago. But it was cloudy. It was cloudy all the way through, and you could see where the thing looked really snapped, really like it was going to go, like if I dropped it, it would have broken into pieces. And you can see now that they're just shadows. They're just, there's an indication there was a line through it at one point, but it's healed. And crystals change, and we change. And there's a lot about how to get a crystal to assist you in your transmutation, in your growth, in your movement through the world. And it really does help. I remember a show done a long, long time ago where there was an enormous crystal, and looking at the rerun, I had put my left hand on it, and it stayed there the whole show. And it really did manage to modify the frequency of the show. They're a remarkable item. If you have one, get it and bring it so it can see its friends here on the air, and then you'll feel it light up and
it really does raise the frequency of a room to have minerals and crystals around. And you know, there are three forms of life here on the planet, which is animal, vegetable, and mineral. And crystals are living things. They're not just some inanimate object.
Yeah,
they do grow. And how crystals grow is it grows around itself and grows around itself. Much like we do when we evolve. It's like the younger part of us is still there, but we get this larger part growing around us. That's how our brain developed and came through evolution, too. You know, we have the reptilian brain, and then the different brains kind of grow over the other ones.
Yeah. It's remarkable the scope of life there is. Actually, anything, an atom is a living thing. Anything made out of atoms is therefore alive. And years ago, people simply could not get to the thinking that the Mother Earth is a living being. It's really true. So is the sun, so is the solar system, in fact, so is the universe. All of this stuff is living. And as long as it's not regarded as living, then you can do as you wish. And we really can put a stop to that whole thought form that you're irresponsible. You can do anything you want to, dig holes, strip mine, whatever you want, and no consequence, and it doesn't work that way. But we're getting more and more conscious as a group, and I do understand that this is rising in us, the level of consciousness that we have. But please, ask people if they, go spend a day asking people if they think the Earth is alive, yes or no. And do your own consensus report on that, because the Earth is alive. It is. It has moods. It's awake. It's aware. It's a living being that thinks. And,
well, thinking of thinking, or speaking of thinking, I feel that minerals, crystals, stones in the planet are the nervous system of the planet.
Yeah.
And that, you know, we in the class we talk more about grids, but gridding just means where you get several crystals to work together for an intention, just like you were to put lots of extension cords around. And so, you know, that's really wonderful.
Yeah, we talk about gridding your house, well, gridding your property. Gridding yourself, there's an enormous part of the class is dedicated to gridding.
Yeah, but for tonight we just we'll have a few little things. This here is a citrine. Now, natural citrine is usually more of a reddish brown color, and what the citrine that we're familiar with is yellow is actually highly heated amethyst, and it turns this yellow. But isn't that lovely? That's for, you know, claiming your power. A lot of people say this is for attracting abundance and wealth into your life. But it makes these beautiful points. This is a really large one, not something that's common. And you can see it has many different points on it, little celestials and things. But it's really a lovely piece. I love it. To me, it gives me a lot of energy to hold this, the vibration of it.
Yeah, the waveform in front is made of aragonite. That's this one in particular. They'll get a close-up of that in a moment. An aragonite crystal is a matrix that can have another crystal at any angle. There's no rhyme scheme exactly. And that's very much the neuron path involved in the human brain, brains in general. We have a few opinion on brains in general. But the aragonite, I spent some time sleeping, holding a crystal in my hand, aragonite specifically, and woke up and brought back a number of short stories
with me
that actually got.
And as a matter of fact, in my descriptions, the little booklet that I've made about crystals, I've called it the author's stone. And I really feel that too. It's a good thing to meditate with when you're writing.
People get a copy of this booklet with the class, by the way. Just in case you're wondering about that.
Okay.
But this is the aragonite. There we go.
Okay. Yeah, go I think ahead. That was already on. This is just another piece of amethyst.
Isn't that
this
beautiful?
Is in its raw point form. Isn't that lovely? This is a twin. You know, it's a lot of togetherness here. Just beautiful. I mean, if nothing else, even if you can't get into the metaphysical properties of minerals, they're just lovely. And you can really feel it when you hold them, too. So that is just a regular quartz with magnesium in it. So they grow very similar to regular quartz, but they're usually shorter points.
Yeah, we have some further crystals.
They tend to grow more closely together than.
To show you, yeah. Just to remind people, this is a live call-in metaphysical show. You may call in with questions, really about any subject at all. We've done dream interpretation. We've done quite a few things. We've translated people's birthdays into Mayan. And we're just talking about crystals tonight.
Yeah, I just thought I'd show a few, and then we can go on from there. It's okay.
Mm-hmm.
The next one is labradorite. This is one of my very favorites. I go through spells where I collect. Now, you see how that's capturing that blue light? This is like a green stone. And each one, let's see if I can get the light. You see how when the light hits it a certain way, it captures it?
There you go. Wow.
There.
That's really remarkable, isn't it?
Let me turn it around a little. There we go.
Yeah, there we go. Mm-hmm.
Now you see how this one has blue and this has like an orangey color in it. Labradorite is just really, really wonderful. Let me show you the side that's not polished also and show you how it catches the light too, but it looks a little more rough. But they're just lovely. And how that happens is they have these little channels in it that are clear, and depending on the length of them, how they capture the light, it will mm-hmm. be different colors. The longer channels, I believe, are the blue, and the shorter the red, or the vice versa. Anyway,
different
things. But it's really good for reinforcing your aura and not letting other people's opinions of you matter so much in your life. You know, we mm-hmm. get kind of wrapped up in that. So it's good for just sealing the aura, especially if you go into a workplace that isn't necessarily the most comfortable place to be etherically. You could take this and it'll help out.
I have one story about that one that's really good, which was someone gifted me a piece of labradorite with I had no idea what this thing was, none. And the phone rings at 6:30 in the morning, and it's a friend of mine, and he goes, can you drive me out to Dulles? And I said, well, do you have $20? And he said, yes. And I said, take a cab, and hung up. And I didn't even think about him till 6 o'clock that night when I started to wonder if he'd landed where he was going. My aura was so sealed that out of a dead sleep, I just shut that thing off mm-hmm. like that. And that's the mechanically sealed. Now, the auric field, it is incumbent upon all of us to work on sealing our auric field. What blows holes in it is fear. So at least that's the formula. We do a lot of work with people about sealing the auric field. Mm-hmm. That is a mechanical assist to the sealing of it. And it will, to whatever degree, the master, meaning you, gets behind that and works it. But this was just an off switch. And we're still friends. I mean, there was nothing, a friend is a word that normally puts you to sleep.
Well, I think, you know, your own guilt, like if we were to feel guilty about saying no, that's what leaves the opening.
The fear.
You know, that I talk about in the opening of the throat chakra.
Mm-hmm.
Person A says, a guy comes up wanting to borrow your keys. Person A says no. And they go, oh, come on. And then person A says, well, you know, I'm going to be using it later, looking for an excuse why they're saying no. Person B just says no. And the guy goes, okay, and walks away. And what is the difference? Person A feels guilty about saying no. Person B does not. So really it's important to make your yeses mean yes and your noes mean no. Because really, yeses mean nothing without no. Mm. I mean, that really, defines the other one. So it's important to know how to say no and not feel guilty about it.
That technique of saying no, if you say anything after the word no, including the word no again, your no loses power dramatically.
Well, you know, and yes, that's very true. And even above and beyond that, if you don't believe in your no, you will find yourself in a position where you're feeling like you have to say no twice. That's a good signifier to let you know that you're comfortable with your own no when you don't have to say it twice.
Yeah, well, that's the power behind it.
Yeah.
Yeah, very much so.
That's one I worked with for a long time, mm-hmm. With that one. Okay, I've only got a couple more here and then we can go on. This one is a lapis lazuli.
Lapis.
And it's a very deep indigo, which is a cross between blue and purple. It's a very good third eye stone. And it is one of the very first stones used to that only royalty could use many, many, like thousands of years ago. It's like discovered in ancient artifacts that the royalty used this. It's a really beautiful color. And the Afghani lapis is really gorgeous. It has pyrite in it, which is looks like gold flecks on the outside. And then this one is fluorite. This is a very deep colored fluorite. Fluorite comes in many different forms, many different colors. Neville and I have specimens of most things that you get to hold when mm-hmm. you come out. Anyway, this is good for grounding, like those, you know, the caffeine high that you get like when you're stressed out. This is a really good stone to hold for that. Kind of pulls you back down.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And there's quite a bit otherwise that we have, as Mary was saying, many specimens that you get to actually experience by holding on to it. This is my kneecap. No, wait. This is a, it's a point. It's a crystal.
That's your knee
it's a piece
point.
Of my knee point, yes. It's a piece of quartz, and it will really seriously amplify.
Neville's a unicorn.
Yes, it will amplify your third eye. It really will. And this particular piece is, well, we'll explain a lot about these things.
That's
there's
pretty.
Thousands of pieces of vocabulary that go with
see,
it, but this is a really
still.
Nice one.
There.
There we
the
go.
The camera people love Neville's.
Ding, 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 ding. It's vibrating. See, look, it's vibrating. It's actually vibrating at 32,000 hertz. Isn't that clever? It vibrates so consistently that we make watches out of it. How
and
about
computers.
That?
Computers.
Computer parts, all the rest of this. Yeah. And as I said before, this is very kin to us. It is remarkably kin to us. So even just holding a piece like this, as you were saying, will instill a sense of calm in the person. It really does work that way.
Yeah, and I use them like as antennas. So if you're meditating and you'd like to get certain information,
mm-hmm.
you can you know, call it across
you're
that.
You're very good at that. Yeah.
Call it across
and
that.
We have our first caller, speaking
excellent.
Of calling. Hi, caller. What's your name, please?
This is Sean.
Sean, what can we do for you?
Yeah, I'd like to have my Mayan birthday done.
Okay, what's your birthday?
It's October 28th, 1956.
Excellent.
Okay. Well,
and maybe a reading, just to touch back. I've been watching you guys for years. It's a great show. I've been
thank
been
you.
Enlightened, and I've really enjoyed it.
Thank you so much.
I've grown greatly since I started watching your show.
Excellent.
And I sort of feel like I'm surrounded by a lot of insanity, and you guys kind of cleared that up for me.
Oh, well, thank
it's kinda
you.
Cool.
What,
fact,
what
I'm like on my fourth job in 3 months, and I'm wondering.
That's a very good sign.
Yeah, I wonder why I keep going from one bad situation to another, and it seems like if life and everything's going great, then these people around me are just like they're out mm-hmm. of their minds. You know.
Well,
okay, you're telling us the answer right then and there. We human beings do not recognize our power. Anything that comes out of your mouth is regarded by the universe as a command.
Yeah.
Thoughts are in a different frequency, but anything that comes out of your mouth is a command. So after the first job, you said, well, that didn't last very long. That better not happen again, which was, of course.
I catch that, and I see the pattern that I sort of like, am I willing myself to keep meeting this, putting myself in
exactly.
situations
and
where...
The
I
other
feel
word,
like I'm calm and everything is fine and I'm really in touch with my feelings and what my surroundings, but then I look around and I feel like it's in slow motion. I see the rest of the world just like spinning out of control.
Yeah, you know, I think too, we get into the habit of, we get very habitual. You know, that is something that's inherently
the word,
born.
Habit.
That's inherently born within us, you
yeah.
know, this
mm-hmm.
way to get things so that we don't have to keep rethinking it. And so I would say, you know, just say I give myself permission to let go of this habit
yeah.
of
yeah.
of that. And what happens then is we start looking at
right.
other things and they kind of fade out. But your Mayan sign, Sean, is Akbal Tone 8. And
ooh.
Akbal means night, N-I-G-H-T in Mayan. And that is, you know, we don't meet that many Akbals. They're usually very introspective, and they govern the dream time
that's me,
and the
yeah,
subconscious.
That's interesting.
And being a tone eight, they're ones to explore options in that realm. Today is a tone eight, so there's no coincidence. You know, it's all very synchronous.
Synchronicity, yeah.
And so you like to explore your reality by going in and seeing the inside mechanisms of it,
mm-hmm.
and things like that. You'd probably be really good at astral travel and things too.
Yeah, I'm really into like deeper meaning of everything.
Yeah.
Since the day I was born, I've always taken life very seriously. Everything is. Mm-hmm. Like I've been told I'm too serious. I need to...
Yeah.
No, whoever gave you that idea is themselves doubting their own ability to be serious.
Yeah.
We teach a class on this particular subject, the idea of you getting in touch with these deep patterns, and which is called Consciously Creating Your Life, which occurs on the last Sunday of every month. And, Sean, you may consider attending that
class.
That's
always a good one.
Dig down and find out what's the layer below.
Well, it gives
you
tools to actually be able to access that and use it to change your life.
Yeah.
Well, I pulled a few cards just to delve into what you were talking about, how you know things going on around you. One of the first signs when I start when I'm at a workplace or anywhere where there's kind of this craziness going on around me, I know that my heart and my head are out of sync. And that my higher self is telling me by the avenue of these people that it's time to leave. And so I know if I don't listen when I'm bored and I hang around, then my higher self, my angels, come disguised as these demonic coworkers to kind of kick my butt out of there. So I think what that's saying is you have grown past this, but some part of you hasn't recognized that yet. But once you do, and so, you know, the harmony is when we have that harmony between our heart and in our head, that's when things really start opening up. And you haven't settled upon a place because you haven't found the right place for you to be yet. And so it is saying keep looking until you do.
Yeah.
And then letting go of the past, erase your personal history. This is so powerful. Like wake up in the morning and just say, I don't carry any of my past limitations with me. That's why people like to, you know, the midlife crisis where we like to just go off and do new things or go move to a strange city is because everyone around us kind of keep this past alive in us. They don't let us grow and become different people every moment. But see yourself as really completely dying and being reborn in every moment. It's really a different way to be.
I've been going through that. I went through a lot of tragedy in the last 10 years, divorces mm-hmm. and loss of a child and on and on and on and on. And
that's a lot.
It has really brought me closer to being at peace with myself, and I'm trying to let go of the past, and then it seems like as I try to let go of it, people around me want me to be that same person that they always thought I was 25, 30 years ago, and they won't let me go.
And that is the secret.
So I've removed myself from them.
Yep, and that is the secret to ascension, or whatever word you want to use, is when you no longer are held fixed in the gravitational pull of other people's opinions of you. Because once you do that, and it does look like they move away for a while, but they do come back.
That's a very positive sign when everyone you know won't speak to you.
Mm-hmm.
You used the word lost, not that we're just wishing to upgrade everything. Regardless of where the word lost may occur in your life, it's a trick being perpetrated, pulled on you, by you. Nothing is done to you, it is all done by you.
Right.
Once we recognize that said child is at a much higher frequency, is in a delightful, heavenly, wonderful place where they are constantly being upgraded, having been on the other side and then come back to this side, we begin a few thousand times, 30,000 times, we begin to recognize that there's no such thing as loss. It's a trick to place your attention on misery. And
well,
so
it's also when you hear the word loss, it's like something you got to keep looking out for, and that kind of keeps you glued to it because you're looking for it. But yes, we understand, though, Sean, what you're talking about, though. You know, in our worldly things, I mean, we have to take the steps that we take to get to the place where we see it as the blessing or whatever.
Yeah, I've realized that now.
Yeah.
Through all of that, I have become myself and my higher self, and that's why I watch you, and it's really has been helpful.
Yeah, well, thank you. Thank you for sharing that, too, because every time we walk through those rooms, you know, because we start on this side of those rooms with the feelings of loss and all these things, and it's a journey that we walk through as we realize it isn't really loss. And every time we heal and get past that, we are healing on behalf of the whole planet. So therefore, the next person that comes along heals a lot easier and faster.
Yeah.
So thank you so much.
The distance between the event and the recognition of it as a blessing, mm-hmm. that distance is a mathematical formula governed by fear, doubt, worry, and guilt. Yes, and the less fear, doubt, worry, and guilt we have, the more direct connect we are to the idea
that
100% of everything that happens is a blessing. In fact, you can just take it on knowing or take it on faith that no matter what it is a blessing. And the distance between you and the full breath, oh, what a blessing, that distance is entirely up to us.
That's right.
And we are trained to think in a way that stretches that distance virtually infinitely. And we have...
Well, just along that vein, and then I know we got some callers.
Yes.
A lot of times people ask me for when is something going to happen when I'm doing a reading.
Yeah, yeah.
And to me, I don't see it as time. I see it as events between you and it. So we can do, like if I'm going to get up and walk out of the room, it's the steps that I take, not how fast I do them, you know, that get me out there. Okay.
Yeah.
And we have
Hi, caller. What's your name, please? Hi. What? You, there on the phone. Speak. Go on. Say hello.
Hello?
I know him.
Hi, Mary. Hi, Neville. It's Trish.
Hi, Trish.
Hi.
How you doing?
Great.
Better
how are
better.
You?
Good, thanks. I have a question about crystals.
Sure.
Last night, I wanted to work on my chakras, and I think, I know I have some safety issues, and I think it's in my solar plexus, if I'm on target. I'm not sure.
A lot of times go ahead.
So I took a crystal and I just laid down and I put it on my solar plexus, and it's just a clear one. And I don't know what stone is good for solar plexus, but I just had this handy, so I put it on my stomach. And it felt like it was burning, and I removed it, but my skin wasn't hot, but it felt like it was burning. So I didn't know what that was all about. I just laid
Well, that
it for
meant
a while,
it's working but. With you, actually. The burning sensation means it's working with you. You've come upon a very real technique of upgrading yourself via crystals, is to place a crystal at a particular chakra. It depends on what it is you're working on. But this is the way it works, and this is the class that we're having coming up is a whole lot of really specific ways to do this.
We get to have stones. Like we've done demonstrations on that. But also what happens is we entrain up, much like when you have the bowls done on you, we are vibrating at a certain hertz frequency. When you have something vibrating at a higher frequency or a different frequency, it entrains you up. And clear quartz is perfect, and that's fine. And what I was getting is that it was vibrating, and you were entraining up to it. It's also a good thing to put stones of a color of a chakra, because, you know, we aren't confined to our body. We're much larger, and color is frequency. So if an indigo frequency is of the third eye and you hold an indigo stone, you are pulling that frequency into your field. So that is a wonderful thing to do. So congratulations.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Also security issues, you know, sometimes the lower two chakras too.
Okay.
You know, maybe getting a red stone of some kind, that might be a good one too.
And as long as the word issue was used, the issue is actually with the word safe, because there really is no such thing as safe or unsafe. It's a lie taught to us by the language we speak. There is no point in the 24/7 that you are not perfectly safe. It cannot be done. Falling off a building, you're perfectly safe. There is no such thing that is not safe. You will falling off a building, you'll shortly be at a higher frequency, guaranteed. There is no such thing that's not safe. The using the word safe, feeling unsafe, is truly the victim mentality. It is our turn to step beyond that, to begin to have victory over victimhood.
I don't know how to. I don't know what other word to use. Then maybe you can help me to describe, like the anxiety or nervousness I feel.
Okay,
let's
do anxiety or stress or the rest of it. Okay, stress is the fear of disapproval, right?
Okay.
Okay, who's the only person on earth who could disapprove of you that it would actually make a difference?
It's me.
Very good. Okay, so it's self-generated lie, stress.
Okay.
Anxiety. How about annoyed? You don't want to be a humanoid anymore. You're going to settle to be annoyed. Okay. It's derivative of fussy. What is the word when things are annoying you? It's the
irritating.
Frustrating. Yeah, irradiant.
Frustrating.
Frustrating. Yeah, yeah. That's just fussy. That entire list of words is made up for people that live in a world of excuse and want a reason not to have power. Do you want to live in that world?
No.
Then stop using those words. Stop thinking that way. and change them to words that actually have power and get traction?
Well, I think, you know, it's a fundamental decision. And you know, everything really can be reduced down to its simplest form, because God makes things simple, man makes things complicated. And we have to, like, trace ourselves back to where the branches get back down to one trunk again and make the decision, is this a safe universe or are you safe within the universe? And once you've made that decision to say, I am going to, underneath everything, I'm going to make the decision that this is a safe universe. And I don't care what it looks like. I don't care that it looks like all these dangerous things are happening or whatever. I'm going to commit to having that belief. That is what is underneath everything else. Once you say, I believe it is a safe universe, instead of saying, I can find safe places within the universe, you are going to fundamentally change everything. So maybe that's a good place to start. Get your crystal and just say, this is my decision. And then everything else will flow from that.
Okay.
Yeah, thanks, Trish.
That
was great. I know that your call really helped a lot of people, because that is not something that's uncommon at all.
Yeah.
So thank you.
We have to outgrow the habit of thinking in these words. They are detrimental to our well-being, out of the habit. And we have our next caller,
I just want to say goodbye to Trish.
Oh, Trish, thanks for calling. As Mary was saying, that helped a lot of people. We can definitely feel this.
Excellent.
So our next caller, hi, what's your name, please?
Hello. I think
you're
it hasn't been transferred
to your head.
Yet to the phone, because it usually makes a little sound.
Okay.
All right.
Well, while that's going on, we can talk more about
Shall I do my next one?
Yeah, sure. Let's do the next one.
Okay. I have amber, and this is petrified tree sap. And one thing about amber I would also like to just let people know, there's some counterfeit amber out there on the market, because it feels almost like plexiglass or a light plastic. And one way you can tell if it's real or not is to heat a pin and put it on there. And if you smell like a tree, then it's real. And if you smell plastic burning, then you will know that it's not real.
Yeah.
Anyway, we tested this and it is real. And it smells really lovely when it burns. Mm-hmm. But it's good for, you know, this is a yellow color, so it would be a good solar plexus stone, just like the citrine. Mm-hmm. And it's helpful in exploring past lives. And it really has a nice vibration.
Yeah, it brings back memories from past lives kind of automatically. That could have been syrup.
Mm-hmm.
And in fact, several hundred thousand years ago, that was syrup.
Mm-hmm.
But now... Mm-hmm. Yeah, interesting stuff all the way around.
So, is it about that time? Almost? Okay.
Almost, okay.
Well, I would like to take this moment to wish Donnie, our director, happy birthday, and Sheila happy birthday. And Sheila's going to actually be doing the duck once we're set up and ready for it. And I'll just do the other stone real quick.
Mm-hmm.
This is sodalite, which you get a lot more about in the third eye class, but that's another good third eye stone.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll stop
it's
now.
Time for the duck.
Got concentration.
All right. That's what they do to orange juice, isn't it?
And that's, you know, concentration is about allowing yourself to really get into something without having your mind split with, oh, I got to mow the lawn, I got to pick the kids up, I got to go to the dry cleaners. And Well, thank you.
I got freedom, and one of the fundamental fears, the fear of death, isn't the fear of death. It's the fear of freedom. Any of the anxieties, what a wonderful word that doesn't actually work, that isn't actually real. But whatever that is that's causing you, pardon the expression, angst, okay, will turn out to be the fear of freedom. It is every time. That is the single fear, is the fear that I'm a limitless creator. Oh my God, no, I'm afraid to think anything like that, because then I'd have to be in charge and have to create, and I want to be told what to do, and I want to sit and be a slave, and yes, ooh, that's the way. And come on, you do nothing but die under this particular yoke. It's time for us to go, freedom, but could you turn up that? Turn that up really loud. We want to hear freedom. Yes, that's the deal.
Freedom.
And whenever you analyze the fears, it will turn out to be, we have great trepidation about change because of the unknown, but we admire and love and wish to create change because of the freedom. Okay, there is no unknown. Get over it. There just isn't. There is only your power. Start to think that way. Begin to act like that. Everyone around you will stop speaking to you but secretly admire you. About 6 years later, they'll start asking you for advice. Bill them. Thank you. And our next caller?
Hi. Hi, Mary. Hi, Neville. It's Maggie.
Hi, Maggie.
Maggie, what can we do for
you? Good to hear your voice.
Yeah.
Oh, it's wonderful to see you both and hear you as well. I'm smiling and gratefully so. I'd like to share a couple of things. Crystals have come into my life recently, and in particular about a 2.5 beautifully clear point, a 2.5 inch long clear point, and I've been sleeping with it and taking it with me to the office. And this morning I was having a conversation with it, and I heard you last week suggest, I believe, Neville, you said ask it a question. If you don't believe it's a living entity, and I hadn't really thought to directly communicate with it quite like that. So this morning I said, I would like to ask you a question, and I received an answer within a couple of hours.
Mm.
And I'm also holding a beautiful piece of labradorite that Mike gave me for my birthday in
July,
and it's about the size of my palm.
Ooh.
And thank you so very much, because I had a very enlightening and invigorating day today, and I believe you said that it strengthens one's aura.
Oh, yeah.
Among many of its traits, and it is exactly what I was looking to do today during all the enlightenment that was happening.
Oh, lovely.
And I specifically set out today to open myself to crystal information, so your show is just perfect for that.
Excellent.
Thank you, thank you.
That's great.
And you attended the class some time ago, I believe. Am I
remembering? I haven't yet, but it is about to happen. Yes, so you're seeing forward just a bit. And I I would love to ask if you would be kind enough to do a very brief reading for me this evening.
Sure, I'd be happy to.
I'm still processing the day and very excited about the events.
Mm-hmm.
And would just love to hear what you might say. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll go ahead and hang up so I can turn the TV back on.
Okay, great.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
The first card we get, Totality. This one speaks a lot of finishing up one thing before we begin another. And I feel like the last year, you were pulling elements in that, you know, processing them to let go of them, whatever that was, just a big time of release. And what you notice and where the highlight is to me where our spirit is now connecting with the physical. You know, sometimes we'll get pulled into being physical and, oh, we're doing well at our jobs and we're really rubber meeting the road, but we feel empty, so we kind of move toward our spirit, and then it's like, oh, I don't want to go out there in the beltway and that kind of stuff. And the real thing is to realize that spirituality is everywhere and to do that integration, and that's where what I feel you're calling to you. And as a result of that, when you call that energy, the things that are unlike that, and this is where I feel like I believe Sean, our first caller, this ties into what he was talking about. Like, once you make that decision that you're no longer going to live in that reality of the limitation, the things that are unlike love, you know, love brings out anything unlike love so that it may be healed. And I guess that's the most concise way to put this. Since you are calling love into your house, anything unlike love came up so it can just be released. And the experiencing, this is a much more serene time coming up for you, where you can just sit and ponder life, and it's not so much of the base chakra trying to keep things going mentality. It's more creating what it is you'd like to have and just watching it unfold. So it feels like a real peaceful time, a lot of healing going on.
Yeah.
Okay.
And this is what this is about. We've come here to assist us to wake up, to change the way in which we think, to change the very words we think in, to become powerful, creative beings. It is the deal. And that's really, truly who we are. So we, this class we have coming up on crystals, which is a very important one. What's this? We're processing information in the background all around. Can you see my brain functioning? Well, I can. So crystals vibrate. They vibrate. Well, there's no telling how fast a human being may be vibrating. It's an interesting thing, the study of vibration. We have another class coming up that is a system of healing that we're offering to people, methods of changing the way in which we think and therefore healing. One part of this class coming up is going to be called the laying on of Moldavite. What is that strange little thing
it's
you have there?
A little green thing.
Now, this thing vibrates at 183...
Whenever.
183 million hertz, okay? Quartz vibrates at 32,000 hertz. An average human being is going to be vibrating in the neighborhood of 90... some of us vibrate considerably higher than that. These are those rare ones amongst us that just give off a field of happiness, and you see them and they're just, and you just get caught in this, and they're really fun, and you're just self-actualizing, and it's wonderful, and then they go away, and your field sets at its normal rate down in the, we don't know where exactly. If you're going to drop your field below around, I've heard it say below around 60, I've also heard it say below around 40, you'll begin to become ill. Drop it to 30, and that's what we would call a serious illness, although I would call it a whimsical illness, but I think very differently. Drop it down around 20, and we don't know if you'll be coming back to join us. Certainly you may, but you'd have to decide to come back to join us. But this idea of frequency, so when you're holding an object that's artificially boosting your frequency. And Moldavite is one of the quickest things we've got of 183 million hertz. Do you understand how totally off the scale that is? That's a remarkable item. It came from another, technically speaking.
Well, it is a very high frequency. I've worn Moldavite earrings for years, and I can definitely tell when I put them on, because we do entrain to whatever the stronger, you know, mm-hmm. higher frequency is, the dominant frequency.
Moldavite falls in the category of tektite. In other words, this was part of a meteorite at one point. No, it is not radioactive. No, it will not hurt you. Now, in the first time I ever put a piece of Moldavite on my third eye, I immediately heard a being saying, "Who are you and what do you want?" Now, one might be offended by such a thing.
I'd fire that voice.
Yeah, I immediately changed my answering machine to say, "Who are you and what it is that you want?" Do we have a call?
Yes.
Oh, pardon me, I didn't realize that. Thank you. Okay, hi caller, what's your name, please?
My name is Rich.
Rich,
hey,
what
Rich.
Can we do for you?
Okay, I want to get my Mayan sign.
What's your birth date?
It's January 16th, 1971.
Okay, well, happy belated birthday then.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. And the other night I had a disturbing dream where I ran into these thugs and I got shot once and I hit the ground. I got shot again and that hurt really bad. Then it went black and I woke up and it kind of disturbed me a little bit. And I was wondering what your thoughts were on a dream like that.
Yeah, well, there's a lot to do that while Mary's looking that up. If you've read the books out, I got shot to death actually in a mugging directly. It did not go to black, by the way. But that is a signifier of the ending. First, let me say that dreams are a laboratory we create in, and you put together a particular formula that you did not like. This is not a prophetic dream, unless you choose that. I mean, you can choose anything you want to choose. We are limitless creators, truly so. Okay, but this was a piece of reality you didn't want to create in 3D. Therefore, you do not have to. Again, I'm telling you, this is your power and your choice, a very important choice all the way around. This was, we've all met the bully. It is the deal with the bully. The bully goes one of three ways. You stand up to the bully and take your best shot, and then they'll leave you alone, maybe even become your friend. You acquiesce to the bully and live a life as a coward, or you get together with everybody else that the bully beats up, and as a group, you take him out one way or another. The power in it is to stand up to it, so if you wish, go and redream that without that particular consequence.
I didn't really even catch what the dream was. Did you say that people were shooting at you?
Yeah.
And where were you at this time?
It was in a neighborhood that I'm familiar with.
Okay. And they were, like, chasing you, shooting at you?
We kind of came across them, and they approached us, and I have a hard time remembering every little detail.
Okay. Well, you know, a lot of times death in dreams, especially if we're the one dying, is because part of us is moving on to or letting go to break away or let open up the field for new things to come into our life. And so, you know, I would say, you know, that whole personal history thing, like just erasing it, letting it go, just say, maybe when you go to bed at night, just say, I release the person that I am today to make way for the person I will be tomorrow. You know, something like that, like have a little ritual in there. Because it could be telling you there's a part of you that it's time to let go of. You know, maybe it might be a part of you that's been taking too much at work, like the boss has just given way too much, and it's saying we've got to just take that part of us that feels like we deserve this and annihilate it so that we can move forward and start being happier. So that might be one way to view that. And it's interesting because your Mayan sign is also Akbal, and, you know, we haven't met many Akbals,
and
here's
Akbal.
Two, but you're tone nine. So this is even a double thing. Not only are you master of the subconscious and the dream time, which is Akbal, but your tone nine, which is a very introspective tone too, also, meaning that when you have things that you know, decisions to make, problems, whatever we call problems, you would tend more to be the one that goes to bed and thinks about it, or goes off, you know, on a camping trip by yourself in the woods to ponder it, rather than sitting and talking about it with a lot of people. And tone nines are very introspective.
Yeah, it works really well.
Yeah, well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
It's great. Thanks for calling in. We have another
Excellent.
Call? Mm-hmm. Do we have another call? We don't know.
We'll debate. We do. Oh, short debate. Hi, caller. What's your name, please?
My name is Achla, and I want to know about the... I love your program very much.
Can I
get the reading for my son, please?
For your son?
Uh-huh. Yes.
Did you have any particular questions, or shall just...
Yeah, I have a particular questions like about his job, and we don't have a house, we don't have money to live, right? We are here for the last 7 years, but could not do anything here, going down by day by day down. So I want to know about what's going on in our life.
Okay. One thing, you know, this seems to be the day for releasing old views of self. And I feel like in regards to your son, he has an idea. He has, like, Deepak Chopra calls it the precognitive commitment or the flea circus. And, you know, you take the matchbox and you open it up and the fleas don't jump out of it because they spent some time jumping, hitting their heads on the top of the matchbox. And then when you take the lid off, they don't jump out because they kind of feel that those are their boundaries. And this is where I feel with your son and you also, just to say, I'm going to totally rethink this. Where am I feeling limited in my life? And let me do that, because this exhaustion talks about stepping on that gas pedal on one hand, but putting the brakes on another hand. And then the comparison, like thinking, other people that have come, let's say you know somebody else has been here for 7 years and they've made it over to this level of success. In other words, don't compare yourself to anything else. Just see your accomplishments and what you have come and done. It's a big thing to move from one country and go into another country and learn everything and start over. And this courage card is talking about it. You know, when you transplant yourself into a place that seems like it's not nourishing, it takes a little while for you to believe in the nourishment, for you to flourish, but that you will, and things will change. Start seeing where you're standing as this fertile ground instead of the wall, and it will come a lot faster.
And again, we human beings do not comprehend how powerful we are. Anything that comes out of your mouth is a command for the universe. If you say, why is it always me? Is that an observation? Is that a complaint? Is that...
command.
Yeah, is that a whine? Is that a... Yeah, it's all those things. It's all those things you can imagine it is. Which one of those things counts? The fact that it is a command. So by saying we are not getting anywhere, we do not have money, we have blah, 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 cancel, we're brilliant. Money comes to us just because it can't resist.
Yeah, that's why I was saying, you know, like to review where you're planting your seed.
And keep saying this, and it will be the truth. Our beloved Adolf said you repeat anything long enough and it becomes the truth. This is the way that works. This is who we are. We human beings are limitless creators, and it's time for us to know this 24/7 instead of just when you happen to be at the peak of some biorhythm, or just when you happen to have the chemistry in your body balanced, to understand this, that we are in charge of this, not God, not the government, not the boss, not the spouse, no one. You are in charge of it. That's it. It's the deal. And we have to be there. We have to. That's a bully speaking. It serves us well when we get to the point that we recognize that we are in charge of our life. Tell your life what to do. And yes, we have another caller. Hi, caller. What's your name, please? Surprised you, didn't I?
Well, I'll do Sheila's reading, her birthday reading. Sheila's in the audience today. And so
all
I'll
right.
pull some cards.
Sheila did the duck, as a matter of fact, if you're looking to place
That's
a
right.
face.
And I remembered. Ah, the master comes to follow you or to be with you this year. And that really is, the master comes into our life when we begin mastering ourselves. And I feel that you have. And this is where he shows up, really to show you how far you've come spiritually. So there's a lot of help. Wow, and you got the consciousness too. Consciousness is, you know, advancement. And this feels like a year where you're really making, it's like the last leg of the race, where you're really coming back to being in charge of things and really seeing things. It's like a year of crystal clarity coming. And the outsider, this is the person that has never really felt like they fit into society all the way, because he came from a much more spiritual place. And this is like where you take the gate out between this world and the other world, and some things are going to really start connecting professionally as well. And there's going to be an opportunity too for you to venture into metaphysics as a career too, is what I feel that's talking about. So especially by October, I feel like a lot of things are going to open up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So excellent. Yeah, no. We're going to, after the show, which is in a relatively short period of time, we're going to be at Ruby Tuesdays in Fairfax Circle. If you'd like to join us, this has to be Thursday night. If this is not Thursday night, this is a rerun, but you may still call us at home, which is 703-860-2333. Nonetheless, presuming there's someone there to answer, we will definitely answer your question.
Hello,
we
have,
a caller. Hi, caller. What's your name, please?
My name is Jim.
Jim, what can we do for you?
I need a Mayan reading for birthday.
What's your birthday?
May 9th, 1964.
Okay.
May 9th, 64. Okay.
And otherwise, we're a show representing the potential that we all have, and potential is sort of in the future. We are saying that you are powerful now. You have been tricked out of not recognizing it, but everything you've ever commanded to happen has happened. And to think that way is a very different way to think than the way we've been taught.
Our caller is an Imix 11. Oh. Imix is Mayan for dragon, and they are very good at starting new projects. They're very conscientious, usually hardworking, and very successful people, and very good parents. They like to start and begin things, so whether it's companies or projects or whatever that is. Being a tone 11 is a manifestation tone, so you've got a lot of things to be doing here in your life. You know, not that you have to do anything, but that you could if you choose.
And there's a lot to it. Imix is the primordial soup also is another way of looking at the potential that lies within it.
Yeah,
very
excellent.
Often family and certainly a... Yeah, excellent stuff.
Well, I don't know if we have any other callers. No more calls. Well, we have, this is a crystal that I'd like to show. This is called a Lemurian seed crystal, and they grow in sand rather than in clusters and caves. And the story that goes behind it is that these, in ancient Lemuria, they would program these crystals and did their own gridding of the planet, and they would plant these things so that many years later we would find them and get information out of them. And they have this, most of them are shaped like this, and this is a twin. And they kind of have a, almost like a peach coloring to them. Great energy though, lots of fun.
Yeah, Lemurian in particular is a delightful being. Yeah, very much so.
Yes.
So we've been creating as we're always creating, and this is a, extremely low frequency generator, isn't it cute? And it's kind of got a different dimension to it. And just as a gift, we'd send out a frequency. There we go. Okay. Now, if you're feeling that, yes, oh, this is the new model. Okay. if we're feeling that, then please give us an email on that if you'd be so kind.
Actually, it tickles to look at
it. I certainly would agree with that. This does do a remarkable job on so many, many levels, and sort of this is a megaphone. If this object in particular speaks to you, again, let us know, because feedback's always an important thing, and so that we can further...
That's lovely.
...further who it is we are, we the human race. There is a grand total of one family on this planet. There is no one on this planet who is not your direct blood kin, not a single person. Not one person anywhere is not your kin. And if we all woke up tomorrow and just got that, there'd be no war. Are you kidding me? War? There'd be no. The structure of money would collapse instantly. How can you charge your relatives?
Although
your
I think
relatives?
Some relatives fight a lot, so maybe we ought to handle that too.
Well, the idea of us recognizing
I
us
understand.
As one
it was
family.
A joke.
Yeah.
Yes.
Is a very important concept for we, the human race, to get, mm-hmm. because we're a little shy on that one. We haven't gotten it yet. And it's the one that's killing us, by the way, as a planet, as a population, as a group of beings. So Mary makes these wonderful candles you see here in the front of the screen.
Okay. We have a few. It was our joy and honor to take you to the door.
And your privilege, if you choose it, to go through.
Yes, thanks for joining us tonight. Thank you.